Steve, an eventful tie. How do you feel about coming out of that level?
Obviously, after the goalie being sent off and going out of 2-0, I'm delighted to be coming back to Craven Cottage, Old Square.
It couldn't have been easy for yourself or the players at half-time going in 2-0 and with 10 men. At the time, did you feel you just wanted to keep the tie alive?
Yeah, I mean, I said to them, I mean, fortunately, we played Middlesbrough in the Youth Cup last year and we were 4-1 up. They went down to 10 men and got back to 4-all. And no disrespect to Middlesbrough, I feel we were a better side than they were. So we always had that in our back of our mind that could happen. And it was important we got the goal when we did. And when you've got people like Pat Roberts on your team, you know, they're always going to pull some bit of magic out that gives the boys a lift.
He certainly did, and he was instrumental in both of the goals. He was like a one-man attacking team in the second half, with all due credit to the other players on the pitch.
Yeah, the boys worked hard, and obviously Moussa making his league debut on Saturday, that took a lot out of his legs, and I can only be grateful for the manager allowing him to play tonight. We always felt he would only go about 55, 60 minutes. And then because of the makeup of the game, it just allowed us to say to Pat, right, well, you just float about now and we've got to try and get the ball to you and you've got to try and do, you know, what you can do. And he certainly got us out of trouble.
And obviously he was supplemented by 9 other outfielders that were brilliant in their commitment and the shape and the positional discipline. You must have been delighted with the application in the second half.
Yeah, I mean, they're resilient. You know, we said from the word go, we've never... hidden from the fact that there would be moments of adversity. They don't come any greater than tonight. As I said, after 20-odd minutes, I'd have just took being in the tie at Craven Cottage, but we're more than in it now.
What was your view of the sending off in the first half? Could you tell exactly what had happened from your position?
Yeah, I mean, Liam was covering round. You know, it's how this law's interpreted because, you know, some always say, well, it is a last man, but the referee just said that he denied a goal scoring opportunity. I think the boy would have probably scored, but Liam was back behind Marek, so you never know, do you? But we have to accept it. I thought the officials had a good game, to be honest. I thought it was a great advert for youth football, particularly the attacking aspect of the game. And we'll both go at it on Monday night, and I'm sure we'll be another cracking game.
Well, it'll be an advert for youth football that, as you say, will be televised on Monday at Craven Cottage. Fingers crossed with a lot of our supporters down there in person to cheer us on. How relieved are you that the tie's alive, we're back in the game and playing for a prestigious place in an FA Youth Cup final?
I'd be lying if I didn't say I wasn't relieved, but I've got to say, I never stopped believing. So that's I've got a lot of faith in this group of players. And like I said, the tie's alive and we'll be ready.
Thanks for your time, Steve.
Pleasure.